I've been a vegan since the 70s. Yes, I'm really old. And since those times, I've seen lots of changes. Some for the good, some a little bit too slow. My friend Hester is going to take you on a journey and explore how food comes from the farm to your plate and why people like me are so proudly vegan.
To find out more about the animals we eat, we need to start at the beginning. The ancestors of all farmed animals were once wild and free. Take chickens, for example. The birds that are nowadays farmed to produce meat and eggs are descended from red jungle fowl, who live in the forests of Asia. The pigs we see on farms today are descended from European wild boars, and they can still be found today in parts of Central Europe. Both chickens and pigs have been selectively bred over hundreds and thousands of years.
Until the 1950s, while many farmed animals suffered mistreatment and neglect, they often had the opportunity to exercise and feel fresh air. Soon after the Second World War, things began to change. Farming methods became driven largely by the quest to produce vast quantities of cheap food. Animals were bred to grow faster, put on more muscle for meat, and give birth to much larger litters.
Gradually, it became standard practice to imprison huge numbers of animals inside large sheds, where light, heat, and feed can be closely controlled. It's known as factory farming because animals are treated like units on a production line, and everything that makes life worth living, like fresh air and exercise, are ignored. I'm at an animal sanctuary to find out a little bit more about the different personalities of chickens and pigs. So who's this?
Oh, this is Kerry. She's about a year old now and coming up for a year old.
So tell me how you got Kerry.
She just found, somebody brought her to us. It's not an uncommon scenario, I think, with piglets, because they're so slippery, if you like, they just escape, and I think they're just so uber intelligent.
And how was she as a piglet? What was she like when she came to you? And do they have different personalities? Do they all behave in the same way?
But no, they're as different as you and I. I mean, some of them are irritable. Most of them, however, are wonderful. They're extraordinary animals and way more intelligent than a dog. I taught, for instance, one pig to sit. It took me about half an hour. And in no time flat, I'd say 90% of my pigs could sit on command purely by observation.
These pigs are clearly very happy animals. In contrast, what's it like for farmed pigs?
It's awful.
Pig farming is amongst the most intensive of all. 70% of pigs farmed for food in this country are reared inside factory farms. They will never see daylight and never feel grass under their trotters. These are the mother pigs, sows, who produce the piglets who are fattened for bacon, ham, and sausages. They are confined in these metal structures called farrowing crates when they are about to give birth, and are kept there for up to 3 or 4 weeks. Farrowing crates are designed to allow piglets to suckle while stopping them from being crushed by their mothers, but they are not natural and deny mother pigs their natural instinct to build a nest and look after their young. After only 3 to 4 weeks, the piglet is taken away. The mother is soon made pregnant again, usually through artificial insemination, and the piglet is put into crowded pens to be fattened for meat. These curious young animals are stressed and bored in their barren and overcrowded crates, often frantically trying to bite the tails off their pen mates out of frustration. Farmers try to prevent this by breaking off some of their teeth and cutting the ends off their tails. Factory farm pigs are specially bred to grow unnaturally fast and put on a lot of weight, which puts a great strain on their bodies and causes painful health problems, particularly to their legs.
On factory farms, the conditions are often filthy, which makes a perfect breeding ground for infectious diseases such as swine flu and meningitis.
It doesn't seem fair that all that happens for the sake of a sausage.
But it's not only pigs that have got this problem. Do you want to come and meet the chickens?
Let's go and meet the chickens.
Come on then.
What do they spend their time doing? What sort of behaviours do they have?
Well, they roam quite far and wide, given the opportunity.
And do they make friends with each other?
Oh, yeah. They make little groups of friends and they all go off together and they wait. And some of them, in fact, I found waiting outside of other ones' houses. They live in different houses, waiting outside for them to be let out in the morning. And when they come out, they play and they all run up and down, completely liberated and free. And I cannot see how that can be fulfilled in any way for them in a farm environment.
They may look different from their wild ancestors, but today's pigs and chickens want to do the same things and behave in the same way. They haven't lost any of their basic natural instincts. Approximately 95% of the chickens farmed for food in this country are reared inside huge sheds on factory farms. There may be 45,000 birds crammed into a single shed.
These birds are growing unnaturally fast. It's like having an adult's body on a child's legs. Those legs just simply cannot cope with that weight. And what we are seeing is a lot of animals that are lame or that are crippled. And these animals actually die because they cannot reach the water, they cannot reach the food.
These sheds provide the perfect environment for infectious diseases to spread.
Viruses that normally would die out in nature are kept alive in the factory environment. People in very close contact with animals can then become infected with these very dangerous viruses and bacteria.
While healthy chickens would normally live for about 6 years, these broiler birds are sent off to be killed after just 6 weeks.
When you open a chicken shed, this is what you see. The size of a football ground, but a massive white. If you can imagine trying to walk in there, pick them up, throw them, catch, catch, catch. If their wings break, they break. If their legs break. Most nights we went out to catch 30, 35,000 chickens, 8 to 12 draws, 30 chickens in a draw, all chucked in a heap together. They'll fit in there on top of one another, but what happens? There's no breathing space, very little air. If they was a bit lively, their heads would be stuck in drawers and you'd shut the drawer and their heads would come off. It's not a nice sight.
In the UK, 800 million chickens are slaughtered every year. Now that's the same as more than 2 million chickens being killed every day.
So what can you do if you don't think this is right? One option is reduce the amount of meat you eat and only choose free-range organic. But even these animals are sent to the slaughterhouse when they're very young. So that's why young people now are choosing a different option.
Yummy, yummy, yummy. So, what do you think of the food? What's your favourite?
I couldn't actually tell the difference between a normal chicken burger and this burger. It's kind of surprising that this is all pure and it has no meat at all.
You can get great Thai vegan food, Indian vegan food. I mean, veganism is a massive thing now. So your options are many and varied. Have you ever considered being vegan?
I definitely have. I feel a lot of the food choices I make as a skateboarder is just fizzy drinks, chocolate. I feel that if I went vegan, it would definitely benefit me.
It would. And you're a sports person, and you know some of the greatest sports people are vegan. Some of our strongest animals are vegan.
Yeah, and
because see, massive animals that are vegan.
That's the thing I find interesting as well, is that the animals that we eat are just eating plants regardless. All of the nutrients, all of what they need is in the plants regardless.
So it shows you, you know, you can get your protein, you can get all the nutrients you want from other sources rather than from animals.
Sasha, have you ever thought about the effects of the meat industry on the environment? 3 years ago, I turned vegetarian, so I did lots of research into cattle farming. The rainforest has been cut down at extreme rates to provide land to farm meat cattle. So that, I felt like that affected me quite personally, and it made me want to become vegetarian. Yeah.
Why don't you just take that other step and go vegan?
I would like to, and I've said for a long time I'd like to. My parents are not as big on it, but when I move out, I think there's a very good chance I will turn vegan.
Cool. Okay.
Yeah, basically.
That was great. It's so inspiring listening and talking to young people about being vegan. In the end, the choice is yours. The fate of millions of animals depend upon the choices ordinary people like you make about the food on your plate. The decisions you make can really make a difference to their lives.